ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه. Here in the first section also we have three ayat in which one supplication, one prayer is contained. And in the last section also you'll find three ayat consisting of that prayer, which those brothers who were there with the Isha congregation, they listened to those ayat in the second rak'ah. رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ جَامِعُ النَّاسِ لِيَوْمِ اللَّا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. Oh our Lord, we know it, that you will gather the whole of mankind and humanity for a day about which there is no doubt. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. That day is to come. There is no doubt about it. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادِ. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't go back on His promises. He has promised that He will gather you, He will reward His faithful bondsmen. He is not going to go back to break His promise. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَنْ تُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. Verily those who have taken to kufr, to disbelief, to denying the Quran and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, لَنْ تُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ. Their progeny, their children, and likewise their wealth and their money will be of no avail to them when they will be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ وَقُودُ النَّارِ. And they have to become the fuel of the fire of hell. كَذَابِ عَلَى فِرْعَوْنَ. Just like the people of Fir'aun. وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. And not only Fir'aun, the other nations before him, before them, people of Hud, people of Saleh, the nation of Aad, the nation of Samud, the people of Lut alayhi salatu wasalam, and so on, the people of Shu'ayb alayhi salatu wasalam, people of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. Now this is the example of the former people, former nations to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent messengers. كَتَابِ عَلَى فِرْعَوْنَ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. They also belied our signs and our ayat, denied them, they rejected them. فَأَخَذَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِذُنُوبِهِمْ. So Allah seized them due to their sins and misdeeds. وَاللَّهُ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. And Allah is very severe in punishment. قُلْ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the people who are rejecting you, قُلْ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Tell them, سَتُغْلَبُونَ وَتُحْشَرُونَ إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمْ. You will also be defeated. You will also be overpowered. In this world, you will be overpowered, defeated. تُغْلَبُونَ وَتُحْشَرُونَ إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمْ. And in the hereafter, you will be taken and driven towards the fire of hell. وَبِيْسَ الْمِحَادِ. And it is a very bad resting place. قَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ آيَةٌ فِي فِيَتَيْنِ الْتَقَطَىٰ. I should have told you that this surah was revealed after the battle of Uhud. That's the difference between Suratul Baqarah and Suratul Al Imran. Suratul Baqarah was revealed before the battle of Badr. And Suratul Al Imran was revealed most of it, except certain parts which I will let you know afterwards. This surah Al-Imran was revealed after the battle of Uhud. So there is a difference of more than 1 year between the time of revelation of Suratul Baqarah and Suratul Al-Imran. Because the battle of Badr was held in the month of Ramadan in the second year after Hijrah. And the battle of Uhud was fought in the month of Shawwal in the third year after Hijrah. So 1 year plus 1 month, that is the difference between the two battles. And now you add something before Badr and after Uhud. So nearly 1.25 years gap between the time of the revelation of Suratul Baqarah and Suratul Al Imran. And most of it you will find 60 ayat, nearly 1/3 of this surah. It consists from ayah 121 to ayah number 180. It's a long commentary by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the events of the battle of Uhud. But here you know, an example is being given of the battle of Badr. قد كان لكم آية في فئتين التقتا. The same thing that is continuing, which was being said to the kuffar who were rejecting Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. قد كان لكم آية في الفئتين التقتا. For you there has been a sign in the two armies that who confronted each other. Here the word Badr is not given, but we know that this example is of the Battle of Badr. قَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ آيَةٌ فِي فِيَتَنِ تَقَطَى. The two hosts, the two armies that faced each other in the field of Badr. فِيَةٌ تُقَاتِلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. One party, one army, one group was fighting for the cause of Allah. That is Muhammad Rasulullah وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ. They were fighting for the cause of Allah. وَأُخْرَى كَافِرَةٌ. The other group, the other party, the other army was of the kuffar, of the non-believers. يَرَوْنَهُمْ مِثْلَيْهِمْ رَايَ الْعَيْنِ. The Muslims were seeing that they are facing an army which is clearly double than their own number. Although the number was three times. But at least it was apparent that we have to combat with an army which is twice in number and strength than ourselves. وَاللَّهُ يُوَيِّدُ لِنَسْرِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps and supports with His help whomsoever He wants, whomsoever He pleases. That is, it's a sign with you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave His help to the Muslims and they could defeat an army which was more than double the number of theirs. They had more arms than the Muslims. But still Allah ta'ala subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to the Muslims. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ. In this, definitely, in the فِي ذَلِكَ الْعِبْرَةً لِأُولِي الْأَبْصَارِ. There is a lesson for those who have eyes, who can see for themselves. So this one event is sufficient to give them the guidance